And the answer here is that actually three of those statements, those three down here, are correct. I'll explain them in a minute. And this one here is not correct. So the formula indeed does have a satisfying assignment. Not only one, it actually has several satisfying assignments. But each of those assignments has the property that exactly one variable is set to true. And I'll show you in a second how that works. And of course, I mean, the last thing was probably quite easy to figure out. As you see, this already has a kind of squared shape. So if we continue like this and add another variable here, then we would have to add another line down here. And each of those formulas grows by one, and the whole thing grows by one of those brackets here for each variable that we add. So the size is O of n squared for n variables. So let me explain this here to you. So there are several satisfying assignments, but each of those satisfying assignments has the property that exactly one variable is true. So for example, let's say that we set x1 to true. Then what will happen is the following. So x1 is true. This means this one down here goes to 0. This one goes to 1. 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 And this one as well. So let's have a look here at this part of the formula. All of the variables here are connected by an OR. So we have x1 or x3 or x4 or x5 or x6. This means if just one of the variables here is set to true, which it now is, then the whole bracket here, so from here to here, will also evaluate to true. And then we take this very, very big not here, which means this will evaluate to 0. Now, if this very big not here evaluates to 0, then we have to make sure that this variable here evaluates to 1, because all of them are connected by an and we are looking for a satisfying assignment. So to do that, we have to set x2 to 0 so that this here evaluates to 1. Now, for the next bracket, it works the same way, because again, we have x1 set to true, so the bracket evaluates to true, so the not evaluates to 0. And so again, we have to set this to 1, which means x3 is 1, and we can go on through this the same way. So the formula forces us to set every variable except for x1 to false. And now the way that this formula is structured, of course, we could also have chosen to set x2 to true, but then if x2 is set to true, we have this here, so x2 here is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, which means in order to get these here to go to 1, so we need to have these here go to 1, because this here evaluates to 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So we have to set all of these variables here to false. Yeah, finally, what about this one here? Well, since x2 is set to true, not x2 is set to false. But luckily, because we've set all other variables to false, so we have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. In this case, the large not here evaluates to true, so this bracket here also evaluates to true, and we have satisfied the Boolean formula.